Good morning. I'd like to thank all of you for being here this morning as we come to honor the memory of Norma Edwards Carter Harris and to celebrate her life. Norma lived a long life, 105 years, and she was an awesome lady. I'd like to read to you her obituary at this time. Norma Edwards Carter Harris, age 105, of Ashland, entered the gates of heaven on September the 8th, 2020. She was preceded in death by her parents, Peter and Annie Edwards, two brother, one sister, first husband, Richard Carter, and second husband, Ward Harris, Sr. She is survived by her niece, Elsie Mae Lindsay, nephew, Elridge Edwards, wife, Mary, G.M. Edwards, Brenda, two great nephews, her caregivers for the past 5 years, Robin and Pauline Hart, devoted friends, Clyde Dalton and Sylvia Gardner, and her church family. Norma was a charter member of Newfound Church of Christ, where she was active up until the last few months. We would like to thank Kimberly of Paradise Home Care and the nurses and the staff of At Home Care Hospice for their kindness and care for Norma over the last few months and days of her life. And at this time, we will have, Miss Norma requested two songs. The first one was When They Ring Those Golden Bells for You and Me. And at this time, we will listen at that.
There's a land beyond the river that we call the sweet forever, and we only reach that shore by faith to see. Yes, I want to see my Jesus shake his and hear him greet us when they rang those golden bells for you and me. Don't you hear the bells ringing? Can you hear the angels singing? There's a glory, hallelujah. Do you believe in that far off?
We are here to celebrate the life of Milma. And Milma was a very private person, as everyone in here knows. But Miss Norma loved her church. Miss Norma was a shrewd business person. When it came to her business dealings, person. She was like that hunting commercial. When we speak, people listen. And when Miss Norma spoke, people listened. And all of us here have probably had one of those moments in our lives with Miss Norma, when she has come and say, this is the way it is. She carried herself in such a way that she demanded respect. And that was one thing that I loved about her. I find that her life was very interesting. And we've had some of those, some of you and I have had that conversation this morning. Miss Norma was born in 1915. She married for the first time at age 31 in 1946. She lost her first husband in 1969 and then remarried again in 1978 and lost that husband around 1990-91. I'm sure Miss Norma's life was full of things that we look at her and remember her as that dignified little lady that came in and sat in her pew. But I was also told this week that there is a trophy in her house where her and her first husband won a dance contest. I would say that that was a surprise to me. But I'm sure her life was full of those kind of surprises that we don't know about. In her last years, she planned well. And she chose, our friend and our minister that was here for years, Claude Dalton, to help her with many of the decisions that she had to make. I was thinking about this as I was putting this together, and I have a feeling that she made the decisions and Brother Clyde carried them out. And later, she delegated that responsibility to Sylvia Gardner, and Sylvia has done a great job working with her in that. She also chose who would take care of her during those last days. She planned well. We can all learn from her. She planned well. And she chose Pauline and her husband, Robert Hart, to help take care of her, which they did right up to the end. And many times, Virginia, Robert's sister, was right there with them. In all of these, Miss Norma had to make tough decisions. Tough moments in lives call for tough decisions. And these are the great moments in our lives, moments when new chapters open up and new avenues have to be taken and new experiences have to be met. And these rites of passages are important times in our lives when all are changed. Think about the changes that have happened in our lives. Think of how we change from childhood and to adolescence. Think about how we change from adolescence into adulthood. Think of the changes that comes as we get older and as we enter retirement years. But let's think about a election. I did some research, and Miss Norma lived through 23 different presidents during her lifetime. That's a whole lot to go through based on what we're going through right now, isn't it? To have to go through that 23 times, actually more than that, because some served two terms. The airplane was invented 8 years before she was born. Some inventions that have taken place since Miss Norma's birth are: in 1920, the hairdryer was invented. In 1921, insulin was discovered. Hearing aids in 1923. And in 1924, frozen food was invented. Can you imagine life without frozen food these days? In 1928, penicillin. 1930, Scotch tape. In 1938, when Miss Norma was 23 years old, the ballpoint pen was developed. Credit cards were developed in 1950. Car seat belts in 59. The internet in 1969. Miss Norma lived through five pandemics: 1918, 1958, 1968, 2009, and 2020. These are tough times that we live in. And tough times bring about a sense of the unknown. We may have some vague idea of what waits for us in the future, but we really don't know until we get there. But the greatest rite of passage, the greatest change, the greatest unknown for all of us will come at death. Now, for those of us that are Christians, we find that the unknown of death is not that big of a deal because death has lost its fear. Death is not fearful because through our faith, we have come to know what waits on the other side for us. And at times like this, we remember the scripture in the 14th chapter of John in which Jesus promises that he's going to prepare a place for us. And he says, if you prepare a place for us, he will come and receive us unto him again, to himself again. When that place is ready, when that place is prepared, when our new home is ready, he will come and get us. Miss Norma's home was ready Tuesday morning, and God sent his angels to usher her into his presence. We grieve over Miss Norma's passing. In one sense, we grieve, and on the other hand, we rejoice with her. Because 1 Corinthians 15:26 tells us that death is the final enemy that will be destroyed. So, you see, it's death that brings us all here today. And we come to witness, we come today not just to celebrate her life, but to witness our faith and to the faith that Miss Norma had in the fact that Jesus Christ was her Lord and Savior. We come here to praise God. We come here to proclaim the reality of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Not just his resurrection, we claim his death was not in vain. We claim that he was victorious over death. And we will not let that silence our witness for him. Psalms 23 is a wonderful psalm. And at one time or another in a funeral, it's going to be mentioned. And it's provided so much throughout the ages to countless generations of God's people. This psalm is a psalm of confidence and trust. It's a psalm of hope. It's a psalm of peace. It's a psalm of love and gentleness and security. It's a song of David. King David knew trouble. King David knew heartache. He knew trials and he knew temptations. King David knew fear. He also knew the depths of his sin. He knew heartache. He knew trials. He also knew, however, his Lord, his shepherd. The shepherd, the one who protects his sheep. Those of us that are sheep are under his care. The one that we can trust. One who can be called upon in times of trouble. The one who would never leave us or never forsake us. But I believe one of the most important words in the book of Psalms is the word through. The scripture tells us, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. You see, death is just a valley that we've all have to walk through. We can't escape it. We can't run from it. We can't hide from it. We may try to deny it. We may postpone it in some way, any way that we can. But that's going to only last for so long. Death eventually catches up with all of us. You see, death is the price that we have to pay for life. But death is different for those who have the Christian faith. Because we know that the valley of death is not never ending. The valley of death ends. We will rest, and we can rest in the assurance that we will emerge through this valley of death to the other side, into God's eternity. Those who place their faith and trust in God will never be left alone. Tuesday morning, as Miss Norma slowly and peacefully slipped into God's presence, 2 weeks before that, she had been fine. She was here at church 2 weeks before she passed, I believe. And it's hard to believe that she is passed from our presence. But at the very moment that she not only experienced death, she experienced that new birth into her eternal home. And she passed from her earthly life into life triumphant and immortal. We all knew Norma's faith. We all knew how much she loved her church. She set an example for us with her faithfulness and attendance. You could always count on Miss Norma to be here Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night. And of course, the Knitwickers, the group that knits and makes the hats and scarves and things for those that are less fortunate. She was part of that group. I remember more than one Sunday morning, standing up here and somebody said, well, where's Miss Norma? She's not in her seat. And by the time the service was over, somebody had gone and checked on her, called her, and found out where she was. Because if she was not here, there was something wrong. We know her. We knew her heart. We knew that she knew her Savior. And at the moment her breathing stopped, we all know that although her earthly life had ended, her heavenly and eternal life was just beginning. She took a step, not into death, but into life. And when she did that, we grieved, and we still grieve for her. But at that moment, we proclaimed our faith in Christ as our Savior. We know that we've not lost Norma, but we've only seen her ushered into another relationship with God. Our Christian testimony today is that God loved the world so much that he sent his only Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but will have everlasting life. Norma heard the plan of salvation, and she was a. She heard the word of God preached. And when she heard that word preached and taught, she believed that, and she believed that Jesus was the Christ, the Son of the living God. And somewhere in her life, she repented of any sins that she had, and she confessed Christ as her Lord and Savior. and she was buried in Christian baptism to wash away her sins. And at that moment, the Holy Spirit came into her life and sealed her as a child of God. And that's the same experience that we need to go through if we are not a Christian. Like I said earlier, Miss Norma was a very private person. But I believe in my heart this morning that if you have not been obedient to Christ, that that was the message that she wants you to hear. And I believe in true Miss Norma fashion, if she was here this morning, if she asked you, are you a Christian? And you said no, I believe that she would say, well, what are you waiting for? Because that's the way Miss Norma was. While we remember her as a private person and a dignified person, those who were close to her knew she loved to laugh. She loved to have fun. She loved to make jokes. She loved other people. She loved her church. You know, I always enjoyed watching Paul Ian interact with Miss Norma and tease her, and they would tease each other, and they would hit each other on the arm and do all this stuff. And I think Pauline brought out a side of Norma that a lot of us probably didn't see. One thing I also loved about Miss Norma that I noticed over the years was when a young child would come up and talk to her or pay attention to her, her face would light up. She loved that. You know, all of us that are here, family, friends, are going to miss her terribly. We will miss seeing her in her pew. We will grieve for her. We will continue to have trouble believing that she's actually gone because she has been a part of this congregation since day one. But I encourage all of us today to remember that Norma lives on. Norma's not gone. She'll live on in our hearts, but she lives on in eternity with her Lord and Savior. She lives on in our thoughts. She lives on in our memories. And most important, she lives on in the presence of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. That was her faith. That was her trust. That was her confidence. That was her witness. Miss Norma had another song that she wanted us to do as a congregation. The sheet should be there on your pew, and it's Beyond the Sunset, and we'll sing, we're going to attempt to sing all four verses, so please help me.
Beyond the sunset, oh blissful morning, when with our Savior heaven is begun. Earth's toiling ending, oh glorious dawning, beyond the sunset, when day is done. Yon the sunset clouds will gather, no storms will threaten, no fears annoy. O day of gladness, O day unending, beyond the sunset, eternal joy. Beyond the sunset, a hand will guide me to God the Father, whom I adore. Oh, glorious presence, His will be my portion on that fair shore. Beyond the sunset, oh glad reunion, with our dear loved ones with gone before. In that fair homeland, there were no pining beyond the sunset forever.
In Revelation chapter 21, and we'll close with this, but this is one of my favorite verses, our series of verses concerning a new heaven and a new earth. It says, "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of things have passed away.'" Let us pray. Father, this morning, as we come to you, and as we pay our tribute to Miss Norman, Father, we realize that this is truly not the end. This is just a step in another direction. Father, we thank you for the assurance that you are with us, that you will never leave us, that you will never forsake us. And Father, we look forward to that day, that one day we will gather with all of your people that have gone before, and we will have a great reunion, and we will fall at our knees and worship you and sing praises to your name. Father, we look forward to that day. And Father, now we ask that you will be with us and you will comfort those that are mourning. I pray that you will give us safety as we go to the cemetery. Father, above all, help us in all that we say and do to bring honor and glory to your name. For it's in the wonderful name of Christ that we pray. Amen. Thank you.